I want to combine four sheets. So it starts with this one, page 16 of the set. And we're going to jump in, and you can see, want to be able to pull this all onto one full sheet and combine those match lines so that we can look at this as an overall job site. Okay, so what we can do there, first I'm going to estimate how big this sheet's going to be, our overall plan, with four of these drawings, 42 by 30, I know that I need it roughly 50 by 100. So I'm just going to come up here under File, New PDF, and then I'm going to type in for my width, 50, and the height, I'm going to go with 100. Because of how this site looks, it's going to stack that way in a vertical orientation. Okay, once I get that set, I'm going to click OK here, and it's going to create a blank sheet for me. Now I can go back to my set, to that first page, and I'm going to use my Snapshot tool. So under Edit, go to Snapshot. The shortcut key is G. And then we can just go through here and draw a shape around this drawing. So be aware of the line work that you want in when you copy these. Don't bring in a bunch of contours and stuff like that. They're gonna make the drawing heavy. Just go in, get the area you want. When you double click to close that, it's gonna turn blue and take a picture of it. That's now on your clipboard. So we can jump over to that blank sheet. I'm gonna use a Control V and paste that from my clipboard onto this drawing. Okay, so that came in and you can see it there. So I can move that over wherever I think that's gonna be. And then we can go on to the next sheet. So we go back to sheet 15, 16. And we can grab another one. So I'm just gonna hit G for that snapshot tool. Go in and grab the area that I want. I'm cutting out the title block because I don't wanna necessarily see that everywhere. And I'm gonna double click. It's gonna take a picture of that. And then I'm gonna go to my blank document again. And I'm going to paste it from my clipboard, Control V. Okay, so now that we have these brought in, we can use those match lines that are in the drawings. If I zoom in here, I can grab onto this drawing here and line that up as best I can with one over top of the other. And if you need to, you can zoom in here too, and with one of them selected, you can use your arrows to line those up a little bit more precise. So, okay, now that we have those lined up, you can see how we're starting to piece this together. Another thing that I might do when I get these, I can hold my shift key and select both of them, and then you can right click and go to group. Now those will be one overall image instead of two. So when you move it, it's not going to unlink those areas. So we'll just continue to go through again and add those other two areas. I'm gonna open up one that's already done. Okay, so now we're looking at the full drawing where we have all of these put together. Again, you can right click and drag a window to select all four of these if you want to, and right click and group them so they all stick together. And then you can also flatten these if you want to. I would recommend doing that. So when you're zoomed in and you try to draw a window, sometimes you grab things and move them all. So select the whole group, right click, and go to flatten. Okay, so now we've got a PDF of the site. Everything's linked together and it's flattened. Another tip that I'll show you guys, I don't have one that is this exact site, but we've also done some training where people will come in to tools, image, from file, and navigate out to, I'm gonna go to my images here, and bring in a site plan. So I can grab this one here, and you can click and drag the image of the site. If you get this off of Google Earth, I always recommend that when you do your screenshot, make sure that you get the bar scale at the bottom, because then we can actually calibrate and bring this to the correct scale. But once we get this Google Earth image on top of our site drawing, now we can select it and go over to the properties and bring that opacity down and be able to see the drawing through it. So if you're doing a site logistics plan or anything like that, maybe some staging plans, this is excellent for that. You can see what the actual site looks like and then where your drawing is at. So very similar to that one where I recommend you getting the bar scale. I'll show you also that one of these, they all come in when I paste them in from the other snapshot. It comes in at the exact scale that I took it from, but I want to make sure that at least one of these I brought in a bar scale. Okay, so now I can actually calibrate this drawing and get some measurements from it. So we're going to do that. I'm going to jump in, zoom into the bar scale here, and I'm going to come over to calibrate in the measurement tab. It's going to tell me to pick two points of a known dimension. Click on that and just come in here and click. Notice I'm snapping to the content of the PDF. That is this button right down here, snap to content. And that's another reason why we flattened it, so that we are able to snap to the content of the PDF. So I'm going to snap at 0, snap at 160, and then type in that 160 feet and say apply. Now we can go ahead and get measurements wherever we want to.